It literally takes 5 minutes to go from drab to fab without even applying foundation. Hi everyone, it's Smitha. Today I'm going to be showing you how to put yourself together in no time with just a few products, especially when you're running late to those meetings or to work. So if you're ready, let's begin. I'm going to start with a simple moisturizer and an eye cream. For moisturizer, I'm going to be using Aveeno, and for eye cream, I'm going to be using the Silk Peony by Tatcha. This is going to ensure that your skin is hydrated and moisturized and looks healthy, especially when you're not going to be applying any foundation. Rather than using a primer and then a sunscreen, I'm going to be using a two-in-one product. This is the Tatcha Silken Pore Perfecting Sunscreen, which has an SPF of 35. As you can tell, I use a lot of sunscreen, but not to worry. I know it looks a little crazy now, but this gets absorbed into the skin pretty quick, and this sunscreen doesn't give you that white cast. With that, this cream also smooths out all the pores on the face, giving you a silky matte finish. So whatever you apply on top of this will glide on smoothly. Next, I'm going to be using the Milani Concealer. This is a true match to my skin tone in the shade 145. And I'm going to use just a tad bit in areas where I have discoloration, including my dark circles, dark spots, and patches. I'm skipping the color correction as well as foundation, and I'm only going to be using a concealer. The important point to note here is the concealer is a true match to my skin tone. I'm going to emphasize on that because if you end up using a lighter shade of concealer on your uneven skin tone, it'll start looking ashy because it's going to combine with the blue and purple undertones of your uneven skin tone and it'll almost look ghost-like. So avoid using anything lighter than your skin tone. I'm going to quickly first blend it out with my finger, and then with a dry sponge, I'm going to make sure there's no sharp edges left. So I'm just going to go around my face one time. And then with the Hailey's Retouch Loose Powder, I'm going to lightly set my face to make sure the concealer doesn't crease. And this will also help to remove any shine and even out all the tones on the face. Using the Benefit Brow Pencil, this is the Precisely My Brow in the shade 4.5. I'm going to use this to lightly fill in the sparse areas of my brows while keeping it looking as natural as possible. There's a spoolie in the back of this pencil. I first use that to brush my brow hair downward so I can clearly see on top and fill it in. And then I use the spoolie to brush my brow hair upward so I can clearly see at the bottom to fill in the sparse areas. When I'm running late, I usually skip applying eyeshadows, but I definitely use an eyeliner to brighten up my eyes. And today I'm going to be using the Wet n Wild Breakproof Liquid Liner. This is an eyeliner pen. I'm going to pull out a small wing and line my top lash line. Using an eyeliner in your top lash line makes your eyes look brighter, wider, and more alert. I like to especially do this when I haven't had a good night's sleep, but I have to look really alert and awake. And I'm going to curl my lashes and finish up with the Bad Girl Bang Mascara. This is from Benefit Cosmetics. And that's pretty much it with the eye look. That literally takes me less than a minute to do. Applying mascara to your lower lashes is optional. If you don't want to do it, you don't have to. I absolutely love mascara in my lower lashes, so I always apply it. But if you're not comfortable, you can skip it. Now, as you can see, with zero eyeshadows and minimal makeup on the eyes, it still looks bright and nice. Rather than using a contour and then a bronzer and then a blush and then a highlighter, I'm only going to be using a blush, but I'm going to be placing it a little different. I'm using a very light blush. This is called Palatial by ColourPop. It's a very light peach tone blush, which I love for everyday use. And I'm going to be using this on the highest point of my cheekbones, dragging it all the way to the temples. That way it gives you a more lifted effect. And then I'm going to be using a lip liner. This is from Ace Butte. I'm going to be using this to line my lips as well as fill it in. Again, rather than using too many products, I'm only using a lip liner. And what I love about lip liners is they're more long-lasting than a lipstick. And I love lip liners that are not overwhelming and they just enhance your natural lip color. And this lip liner is one such. although this is very minimum makeup, if you want this to last the entire day, it's important to lock it. And for that, I'm going to be using the Benefit Super Setter Setting Spray. This will form a thin layer over your skin. It's like a film over your skin, and it'll not let your makeup move, making it last the entire day. And what's nice about this kind of makeup is your skin still looks like skin, but just a healthier, better version. And the makeup itself is not overwhelming. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please thumbs up if you did. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing. I post several times a week. For your convenience, I'm listing all the products that I used in the description box right below this video. I love you guys so much, and I will see you soon with a brand new one. Bye, guys.